Wolfenberger wins the draw. Shot from the blue line is knocked down and cleared back out to center. Rickard Persson got the
shot. Whoa!
And now in front we've got Felix Potvin into a scrap.
Andre Roy is going to be in trouble, but he can handle himself up. Now Yanni Hermé, he left his crease. The goaltender down at the other end left his crease. And look at Felix Potvin. He's down right here, and he is upset. The linesman is trying to get a hold of Potvin because he would create the outnumbered situation. This way here, it's 5-on-5.
Well, I'll be honest, I did not see what happened in front of the net to get the
Roy got caught behind. And Potvin, Bob, I think, gave him a little tap with his stick. But then as they turned around, and now
somebody
Adam Mayer came off the bench.
Yeah.
And that's going to cost him 10 games.
That's because Alaranta was getting hammered.
Well, here we go. We have some more stuff going on.
Haven't seen this in a long time. Now here comes the goaltender for Ottawa, Yanni Hermé.
And that's going to be an automatic penalty.
That's 2 minutes to him, and now we got Potvin. Potvin got into it once years ago with Ron Hextall, and Potvin really handled himself well.
And Bob, this is a situation as both guys scrap where I think referees should have the authority right here to hand out a suspension. And I know that sounds weird, but right here in this situation, the referee should be able to go up to a player and say, one more punch, it's gonna cost you more than a game misconduct.
Now the players on the bench are helping Hermé get his glove off.
Wow, this is weird. And we have that on video. That is really weird.
So Potvin and Hermé, the goaltenders. Everything else? Well, not everything. There's still a couple of players down in the corner. Well,
I think the first punch, Bob, was thrown by Andre Roy. And any time, you know, it's an unwritten rule in the NHL. You throw a punch at a goaltender, and I know I kind of reacted. I went, wow, because you know he's going to be in trouble. He knows he's going to be in trouble. And there's the cat. He is dead tired. I'm sure Hermé is dead tired, too. This is going to be a difficult thing. I think it was Adam Mayer, the Kings, Bob, that came off the bench first.
Yeah.
And that is automatic. Automatic suspension will be handed down against the first man to leave a bench. I don't think that anyone from the Ottawa Center has left the bench. If someone followed Adam Mayer over, it would be automatic too. We noticed it, Bob. It's been a weird game from that standpoint here in the second period. We're going to take a look to see how it started. You'll see the face-off one. Now here obviously is Felix Potvin. Now watch Waugh back in. And there's incidental contact, not much. Not much happening. Waugh goes down. You see the referee here. Doesn't call a penalty. Now watch Potvin. He'll give a little bit, a little bit of a back thing. Now watch Andre Waugh as he comes up. He tries to just look at it and then boom, right there. That's enough. Cat comes back with the blocker himself. And then Waugh knows he's in a situation where he's gonna have to pay for it. Looks like LaPerriere gets involved right down there. And then later on, over at the bench, look at this. Bob, I hate to laugh, and I don't, I've never seen this before.
Yeah.
The bad part here is, you know what, I'm gonna say it, it's WWF-ish right there. It's kind of like a tag team, and the guys over the side are gonna help out. It's just a spectacle, but it was smart by Hermé. He knew he couldn't get his glove off. And if you have those big gloves on, you can't grab on to a jersey. And the reason a goaltender can't get that glove off sometimes is because they have a buckle there, and they buckle it tight to their wrist. So if they make a high glove save or a hard shot, the glove doesn't fall off at the same time. So we're going to sort things out. We're going to pick up a lot of sticks, a lot of gloves. We're going to get some IVs for the goaltender to rest. And we'll be back. It's tied up 1-1. Off the face-off, here's Felix Potvin. Waugh's gonna back in. Not much happening here, and it's not. Now again, there's no penalty gonna be called by the referee, but watch Felix Potvin. He does have a leg whip. Now he feels like Waugh's in his crease right there with the back. Then they turn, and Waugh tried to pull his feet out. Now who throws the first punch? Again, it's Waugh right there, and you see the head snap back by Potvin. Then Potvin came through himself. Here's Alaranta. You see, can you stop right here, guys? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's five Kings. And Adam Mayer is not one of those guys. So, even if we didn't see it happen, there's no doubt Mayer came out of somewhere. And look at Big Zdeno Chara, number three. And again, at 6'9", 255 pounds. You see him wrestling right there?
Yeah.
Mayer? Chara's father, Bob, was an Olympic wrestler back in the old Czechoslovakian days. And Chara has done a lot of training with wrestling, just to kind of get in shape.